medical aid or food aid. Pero paano kaya, Madam Chair, ginamit itong 40 million na ito as a medical and food aid ng ilang tao in 11 days? So, yun po yung tanong natin, Madam Chair.
Madam Vice President.
Madam Chair, the subject of this hearing is the MVP 2025 budget proposal. We do not have an item of confidential funds in the OVP budget proposal.
Yeah, you're sagutin in that.
Ang pagpapagang mga balita at pagtamagay sa mga isyo na lipunan. Pusa! Opinyon, pala at paglalantad sa katotohanan. Pusa! What you see is what you get. You decide.
May continue, Madam Chair. Isa sa bumubukol na confidential fund ng OPP noong 2022 ay nasabi ko na, Madam Chair, yung medical and food aid at saka yung mga purchase of supplies. According to the accomplishment report, the OPP spent 40 million now for medical and food aid in 11 days. So, ang ibig sabihin nito, Madam Chair, counting math, pumapatak na 3.64 million kada araw ang gastos, no, para sa food and medical aid. So hindi natin maintindihan, Madam Chair, paano ito ginastos in 11 days, no? 3.64 million kada araw dito sa item na ito.
Madam Vice President,
comment.
Madam Vice President,
hindi na call you, ma. It was Representative Arroyo who called you.
The chair would like to remind both the resource persons and the members to please wait to be acknowledged before you speak.
Yes, ma'am.
So, you mean, yes.
For what, ma'am?
Parang sinisilaban si Inday sa upuan.
So, any comment, Madam Chair, dun sa sinabi natin based dun sa accomplishment report. So, kung gagamitan natin ng konting math, 3.64 million kada araw ang gastos para sa medical and food for 11 days. For how many people ba itong ito?
Madam Chair, the topic and the invitation of the House of Representatives to the Office of the Vice President for this hearing is the 2025.
Ayaw talagang sagutin po.
There is no confidential funds in the 2025 budget proposal.
Yung sagot niya.
For the information of the body, the letter that we sent our Madam Vice President reads as follows. In the second paragraph, we noted the following topics to be discussed. Item number 3 is comparative budget allocation and utilization rate from fiscal year 2019 to 2023. That's item number 3. So I can provide you copies of the letter. So clearly, confidential funds spent in 2022 falls squarely within that. So yes, Honorable Francie, may proceed.
Yes, Madam Chair. So mukhang di na tayo sasagutin ng sasagutin ng ating Vice President. So sa bawat sagot kasi na ganyan ng ating Vice President, for the record, since ayaw magpaliwanag ang VP, so ibig sabihin nito, yung paggastos ng 125 million ay na pera ng taong bayan ay hindi maipaliwanag. So yun lang, Madam Chair, kaya hinihiling natin sa Vice President o OVP na kailangan na maipaliwanag itong mga tinasabing item dito. Anyway, Madam Chair, sa kanila naman ang galing, no, yung utilization of confidential and intelligence fund. And of course, ito lang naman ang hawak ko din dito, yung notice of disallowance. Kaya gusto talaga nating maintindihan, Madam Chair, kung ang notice of disallowance ay, so syempre, papaliwanag pa nila yan. Kung paano, di ba? So kailangan malaman din ng taong bayan na sila yung nagbibigay ng pondo para sa operations ng OVP at lahat ng mga agency. At kailangan yung may paliwanag. So hindi pwede yung ganyan na yung tactics na ganyan, na parang ano no, parang sorry for the kusit, na kapag nasusukol na ang kusit, ay nag-aano ng maitim na pinta. So, ayaw natin ang gano'n, Madam Chair, kasi yung atin namang pinag-uusapan dito ay budget. No,
sa inyo yung full story ng balitang yan, click subscribe muna dito sa ating YouTube channel and hit the notification bell para lagi po kayong updated sa mga kaganapan dito sa ating bansa. Like and share na rin po ninyo ang ating video at huwag na rin po ninyo na skip yung ating mga commercial ads para tuloy-tuloy lang ang pag-unlad ng Bagong Pilipinas. Sa mga nagana po ng Malinis and Spaces Fitness Gym, pumunta lang po kayo sa aming Colossal Fitness Gym. We also offer grab car rental with our brand new 2023 model ng Toyota Innova. We also accept booking for those who are planning to travel via PAL, Cebu Pacific, and other airline companies, local and international, and bills payment for Meralco bills, Aleco bills, PLDT, etc. Ang Colossal Fitness Gym is located at 3rd floor Security Bank Building, Lanco Business Park, Legazpi City, Albay. For inquiries, look for Jilon Maravillas, contact number 0966-802-0949. Yan po yung aming ano, Innova. Lagi na pong matao sa amin. Yan po mga bagong clients namin. Napakaganda at colorful at napakalinis ng aming gym po. Pati mga foreigners po pumupunta sa amin, mga British ano, tourist po sila dito sa Legazpi. Na-set up na rin po yung aming mga brand new gym equipment. May treadmill na rin po kami. Ito naman po yung bago naming product na binibenta online. Eye Glow Serum, whitening po siya. Tingnan ninyo yung epekto sa aking anak na architect before and now. Yung mga inquiries po ninyo, dumiretso na lang kayo sa kanyang Facebook account, Riz Maravillas. Ito naman po, Firmax Firming and Lifting Cream, pinapahid po sa mga pulses in affected area. Mainan po sa paninigas ng mga kasukasuan. Ito naman po, Automax Radiant Serum. Sa mukha naman yung application, anti-aging po siya. You will look 10 years younger than your age. Sa mga cancer patients naman po, baka lang gusto ninyo itong itry. Nengsha Red Mix Food Drink. Hindi mo po siya gamot, food supplement siya. Kaya lang, gawa siya mga kababayan sa Goji Berry. Yung Goji Berry, may anti-cancer properties. O ngayon, yung mga inquiries ninyo, dumiritso na lang kayo sa aming messenger sa Facebook para masagot namin agad. Ayos pa? Ayos na ayos niya, Mr. Maravilla.
Huwag naman mag-ugaling pusit ang Office of the Vice President.
Madam Chair, may I point of information only, Madam Chair? May I? Madam Chair?
Before we proceed to the next person on the list, I believe that our former President,
mag-abogada si, ano, si GMA. Kay Inday.
In relation to the point of order, because in the beginning, it was settled that the issue would be the 2025 budget. And in all our hearings, to what I recall, when we want to question something about performance, we question the 2024 budget, not the 2023 budget. What is being questioned now is the 2023 budget, which was discussed very extensively last year. And that is the reason why the House removed the confidential funds. So that issue has already been, to my mind, for purposes of the budget hearing, laid to rest. So that's my observation, Madam Chair.
We know that, Madam former President, but of course, we know that yung pumpondo ng 2023 ay, of course, pwede pa rin maging continuing appropriation hanggang 2024. So in the same way, 2022 pwede maging continuing pa rin 2023. At alam din po natin, last year, pinagdepatihan po natin ng matindi itong 2022 confidential funds. And in fact, we left a homework for the COA. Sinabi natin sa kanila na kailangan nilang tapusin
ang audit by November, I believe mid-November of last year. And since then, hindi na natin alam kung ano nangyari. So that's the reason for why tinatalakay natin ito. And it's a big amount of money. I believe we owe it to the people to understand what happened. Of course, tinanggal na natin noong 2024. Gusto natin malaman, tama ba yung ginawa natin? Kasi baka naman nagkamali tayo. So I think it's worth assessing what we did in 2024 in order to know what to do in 2025. So with that, let's proceed with our next interview.
May I?
Is this just a point of order?
Not a point of order, but
unless it's a point of order, you may wish to be listed. I can put you here, sir.
Parliamentary inquiry, Madam Chair.
Yes, you
may. Parliamentary inquiry. May I ask if the person is required to answer
Kalyado ni Inday.
A question that is related to a commission on audit notice of disallowance when she already said she's not going to answer. Also, the notice of disallowance is addressed to the office of the Vice President. And just to make it clear, a notice of disallowance is not a judgment. It is a request. It is an order from the Commission on Audit for the particular office to explain what are the particulars. At saka hindi na yan legislation side. That is already on the accountability side in the budget cycle. So my parliamentary inquiry, Madam Chair, is that nagsabi na nga siya na hindi siya sasagot, and it is related to the COA notice of disallowance. And just to add, sinabi na rin ni former President, it was thoroughly discussed in the previous year. In fact, tinanggal sa budget ng 2024 yung confidential fund. And we know that there's a pending case on that also. To discuss that further might somehow prejudice or be biased whatsoever. So, yun lang po, Madam Chair.
Alright, salamat. On your inquiry, the only requirement is to provide a direct response on the question, meaning to say a response that is directly related to the question. Meaning to say, kung may question at ayaw niyo pong sagutin, sagutin niyo ng diretsyahan na hindi po ako sasagot dun sa tanong. Ang problema po kasi, ang response ay naging hindi related dun sa tanong. Halimbawa, may tanong, ang sagot ay paglalarawan doon sa nagtanong. So, hindi naman yon klaro na hindi yon directly related doon sa tanong. Kaya, yun po. I think it's a reasonable ask. If there's a question, you may or may not answer. You're not compelled. But you just please say, I do not wish to answer. That's it. And at least we know it's a direct response. And with that, we move to the next person on the list.
Madam Chair,
hindi na po tayo matatapos.
Yan ang sinabi ko sa iyo kanina. Ayaw mo maniwala sa akin eh. Aabot talaga tayo ng bukas dito.
Matindi diba? Po.
Madam Chair.
Hindi talaga naturuan ng tama si Dai.
He said, yes, and yes, please, ma'am. I remind also our first persons to please act in a respectful manner. Sensyo na po, hindi po kasama sa poder ninyo ang pagpa-fire ng presiding officer ng hearing na to. So, yes.
So, if you allow members of the House of Representatives lines like what you just said, like pusit, bakit mo ako kinu-crucify for saying a fact that somebody is convicted of child abuse sitting the chair. Pusit? And then,
malayo na sa topic si Inday.
Out of
order.
So, bakit?
Yes, we...
Bakit napaka one-sided nito?
Note po.
Dahil ba madami kayo dyan sa kabila at nag-iisa ako dito?
We note all your comments, ma'am, and let us now proceed. Thank you. Good ma'am. Ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Madam Chair, point of order.
Yes, the Honorable Benny Abante.
I just came in and I hear this.
We're not talking about the budget. We're accusing each other here. I'd like to find out from the resource speaker if this is the kind of hearing that we're going to have.
Sir, I am not the presiding officer of this hearing.
I know.
Yes, sir.
But the thing is, you're asking questions, Madam Chair. The speaker
correct.
Does not have any right to ask questions. Or do you have?
Where is that?
Madam Vice
in your rules that
Madam Vice President's
person
is a budget hearing.
Request for determination. Some order, please. Yes, Honorable Benny Abanti may proceed.
I'm just asking a question.
Napakabastos ni Inday.
Speaker, you know, because she's asking a question and she's accusing some of the members of this committee. I just would like to find out if we are the ones that have the right to ask questions and it's her right is to answer the questions of the committee.
Okay, so we
have sa akin yung point of order, Madam Chair.
Yes.
You understand,
sir?
Yes. Madam Vice President, am I right?
No, sir. I'm gonna ask the,
no,
so, the chair to ask
si Inday ng presiding officer.
What are my accusations?
Please wait to be recognized, ma'am. Pasensya na po. So again, I'd like to remind our resource persons that you are here, you're invited to answer, to present.
To answer questions.
Thank you very much. And at this point in time, you're here to...
Para i-approve yung budget niya, dapat sagutin niya yung mga tanong. That simple.
And we request you...
Si Inday na yung nagtatanong.
With that,
arrogante talaga. Walang manners.
Recognize for the majority, the Honorable Milagros Aquino Magsaysay. You have the floor, ma'am.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Magandang hapon po sa ating lahat, sa ating committee chairperson, at sa aking mga kasama sa Kongreso, at ganun din po sa ating mga panauhin mula sa OVP sa pangunguna ng ating Vice President, Sara Duterte, Carpio, at iba pang sangay ng gobyerno. Madam Chair, meron lang po akong dalawang maikling katanungan na nais kong mabigyan ng linaw. Ang una ay nais kong itanong sa OVP kung meron po bang mga programa ang inyong opisina patungkol sa ating mga minamahal na senior citizens at kung meron po, pwede po bang paki-furnish ang aking office ng listahan para naman po alam ko kung ano po ang isasabihin ko sa aking mga senior citizen na pakinabangan naman sa Office of the Vice President. Pangalawa po sa COA, nais ko pong itanong para po sa mga hindi masyadong nakakaunawa, pakipaliwanag po kung ano ba ang ibig sabihin ng Notice of Disallowance at ano po ba ang ibig sabihin kung ang iyong opisina ay mabigyan nito. Yan lang po, Madam Chair, at muli, magandang hapon po sa lahat.
Salamat. Let's begin with the first question, Madam Vice President.
Madam Chair, we do not distinguish for the recipients of our projects. Senior citizens can readily avail of the medical and burial assistance, the magnegosyata dai, and other projects of the OVP, including the Kalusugan food trucks during calamities and the libreng sakay. So, hindi po kami nag-exclude ng mga senior citizens. Welcome po sila lahat sa mga projects ng Office of the Vice President.
Salamat, Madam Vice President. So, pwede kong sabihin sa aking mga senior citizens na pwede silang mag-avail ng medical assistance and financial assistance.
Yes, ma'am, of course. And
thank
then
you.
We do have the senior citizen express lane, ma'am, for senior citizens.
Thank you.
Sa aming mga opisina. Your second question, ma'am, is the notice of disallowance.
Vice President, I believe that that was addressed to
sa
the court.
Po in yung question.
So, okay. Which means the chair recognizes our Assistant Commissioner Alexander Oliano, sir.
Madam Chair, good afternoon. Ang notice of disallowance po ay, ang ibig sabihin niya, hindi pwede yung expenditure kasi either you irregular, unnecessary,
irregular,
excessive, extravagant,
uh-huh,
or unconscionable. Pero hindi po nangahulugan na pag may notice of disallowance ay yun na yung final kasi meron pa pong appeal process sa commission. Hanggang hindi po na-resolve ng commission proper yan, doon po masasabi talaga na yung ground ng notice of disallowance ay tama. Pero meron pa rin pong karapatan ng persons liable na mag-apila sa Supreme Court po. Ang final determination po doon sa notice of disallowance sa Supreme Court.
So, ibig sabihin po nito, kung may notice of disallowance po, ay ibig sabihin hindi tama yung paggastos ng pondo. Ganun po ba yun?
Yun po yung naging evaluation ng auditor na nag-audit po ng
transaction.
Salamat po. That's all, Madam Chair. Thank you very much.
Ito yung presentation ni Congresswoman Soan Singh ng budget ni Inday sa confidential funds na disallowed. Ito yung presentation. Pakinggan po natin.
Chair, I prepared a few slides for presentation to the committee. Madam Chair, may I request for the permission of this committee to show the slides on the screen.
Committee Secretary, kindly upload.
Madam Chair, given the volume of the documents, I have created this chart to summarize all the pertinent information with regard to all of these documents summarized across the different quarters. First, I would like to highlight the number of days by which the 125 million pesos was spent across the four quarters. In the first quarter, it was spent within 11 days, that is the period of December 21 to 31, 2022. For the first quarter of 2023, it was spent in 52 days between February and March, 67 days for Q2 2023 and 79 days for Q3 2023. And if you average that out, Madam Chair, as you can see there, we're looking at 11 million, 2 million, 1 million, and another 1 million for each of the quarters. And here, Madam Chair, I would like to now move to the highlights of the findings of the Commission on Audit. So here we will see, I've segmented the 125 million between the two. First is allowed in audit and either disallowed in audit or questioned in audit. So for the first
disallowed
quarter, for the fourth quarter of 2022, which is the subject of the notice of disallowance, we can see here, Madam Chair, that out of the 125 million pesos in confidential funds from utilized from December 21 to 31, 2022, 73.287 million was disallowed in audit by the Commission on Audit, and I will give the Commission on Audit the time as well later to elaborate on that. And 51.7 million was disallowed in audit, allowed in audit. Here, Madam Chair, you would see that across the three succeeding quarters, the three succeeding quarters, while not yet or not subjected to the notice of disallowance, has already received the audit order memorandum with particular findings. So here, Madam Chair, you would see that on average, 53%, 49%, and 28% of the amount in question was questioned by COA in the succeeding AOM. So perhaps, Madam Chair, I will do that as well, divide it per day, just to contextualize it. So for the first, for the fourth quarter of 2022, 6.66 million pesos on average daily was disallowed in audit out of the 11.3 million pesos spent by the OVP between the period of December 21 to 31. 1.2 million in the next quarter, 925,000 in the next quarter, and 443,000 in the next quarter. So, Madam Chair, I will stop here for now and throw a question to COA, if I may, Madam Chair, to the Assistant Commissioner. May he please elaborate on the grounds for the fourth quarter of 2022 for the disallowance of the 73 million, which translates to 58.6% of the expenditure. May I ask COA as to the nature of the disallowance? And for the succeeding quarters, may we ask COA, Madam Chair, to elaborate on the nature of the issuance of the questions under the AOM? Thank you very much, Madam Chair.
Assistant Commissioner Juliano, you have the floor, sir.
Madam Chair, may I be allowed to explain the reason of my presence in this budget hearing?
Yes, please proceed.
This is in connection with the invitation of Honorable Elizalde Co to our chairperson, Gamaliel Cordova, who is now attending a Senate hearing on the revised audit code of the Philippines. And he instructed me to represent him in relation to the subpoena to Sustecom issued by the Committee on Appropriations. I would like to explain that we have a dedicated office that is the Intelligence and Confidential Fund Audit Unit that exclusively audits the Intelligence and Confidential Fund. It is not revealed to any other office, even my office. I am overseeing the special services sector and local government audit sector. Thus, I could not give you the details or the specifics about the audit of the disallowance. And we already submitted our compliance with the committee. And I'm not the proper person to explain the details of the notice of disallowance. Thank you.
Honorable Wensing.
Madam Chair, the reasons behind these disallowances and the questions under the AOM are detailed in the notice of disallowances and the AOM. So in the absence of a response from COA, may I quickly highlight, Madam Chair, the highlights of the different documents?
Please proceed.
Thank you, Madam Chair. For the notice of disallowances, the nature pertain in the non-compliance with item 4.8.5B of Joint Circular Number 2015-01, which is the non-submission of documents evidencing success of information gathering and or surveillance activities. And for the others, Madam Chair, COA did not allow the inclusion of rewards of various goods as supplies, as indicated in the menu category. And that is actually, Madam Chair, very similar across the board. You would see that the AOMs have a very similar nature in terms of the questions posed by COA. It really pertains on the same issues at hand. If I may request ComSec to please move to the next slide.
Yes, but you have 30 seconds left.
Thank you, Madam Chair. I will wrap up.
Yes, please.
Slide 3, please. Pakilakihan, please, ComSec. Here, Madam Chair, as you would see across the board for every single one of the quarters in question, there seems to be a pattern, Madam Chair. Here you can see that the categories are the same in terms of expenditure across the different quarters, which makes sense given that there's a menu within the joint circular for the different categories through which the confidential funds may be utilized. But two things, Madam Chair, that I would like to highlight here. Given that there are differing number of surveillance areas for each of the different periods and the number of days, even though, for example,
okay. Thank you, wrap up.
Sorry, Madam Chair, my laptop is freezing. Regardless of whether or not the number of areas surveillance is 111 or the upper bound, which is 132, the pattern of spending seems to be the same across the different quarters. And also the line items questioned by COA in terms of, as you can see here, the ones in orange are the same. It's with regard to the payment of rewards, the provision of medical and food aid, and the payment of incentives and traveling relative to the confidential operation. So, Madam Chair, in this very heavy slide, all I would like to highlight is there seems to be a pattern. there's a pattern in terms of expenditure regardless of the amount of work entailed, and the pattern as well in terms of questionable categories on the part of COA seems to be the same as well. And Madam Chair, just to close, last na talaga Madam Chair, next slide. Next slide as well. Comsec, next slide please. Madam Chair, just to highlight, in peso terms, in terms of percentages, in terms of the notice of disallowance for Q4 2022, siguro po mahalaga for us to contextualize it in terms of peso terms. So for Q4 2022, dun po sa pinag-usapan natin na 125 million pesos in confidential funds na nagastos po in 11 days. Sa bawat 10 piso po na ibinigay, ipinagkatiwala po ng taong bayan sa Office of the Vice President patungkol po dito sa confidential funds, 6 na piso sa 10 piso yung sa palagay po ng COA ay nagastos sa hindi tamang paraan. So, mahalaga po, Madam Chair, na makita po yon sa ganong konteksto. And looking at the percentages, it seems to be the same in the succeeding quarters. I would not preempt it given that the audit is still ongoing. But in Q1 2023, that's 5 pesos out of 10 pesos. For Q2 2023, that's 5 pesos as well out of 10 pesos. At sa Q3 2023 ay 3 piso sa 10 piso. So ganun po, Madam Chair, it's important to ask for accountability given
pitch
the oversight functions
nito,
of the House as well.
Kababaya?
Aside from scrutinizing the budget, making sure that we
or
put the right resign budget where they're needed. It's also the responsibility of the House to exercise oversight and ask for accountability. So, Madam Chair, yun lang po. Gusto lang po natin siguraduhin na nagagastos po sa tama yung kaban ng bayan. Maraming salamat po.
Salamat, Madam Vice President. Wish or...
And it's more important than the answer.
I will repeat what I said earlier. The subject matter...
Pumusok na si Inday. Sunog na sunog po. Highly anomalous, madaling sabi. Sa kada 10 pesos, 6 pesos ang nagastos sa hindi tama. Sa 125 million, yan ang ibig sabihin nun. So I think malamang yung kinatatakutan ni Inday na impeachment, baka may mag-submit na po. At kung may mag-submit po para impeach si Inday sa hindi tamang paggamit ng pera ng bayan, deserve po. Justified. Walang politika. Kundi dapat talaga papanagutin si Inday.